Bayern is unstoppable. The successes of Solskjaer and Lampard, Messi's magical substitution, and Ansu Fati's severe injury. Football doesn't stop to take a break, and top matches are played almost every day. Keeping track of everything is very difficult, but subscribing to our channel will definitely help you with that matter. Guys, this week closes up with a super match of the Premier League, Liverpool-Man City. Before we start, write your prediction for the match in the comments below. It's gonna be extremely interesting. And for the perfect balance in the universe, it remains only to smash like under this video. Done? Well, now we are about to start. Lionel Messi scored his first goal of the season against Betis. He also scored one from the penalty spot. The game versus Borussia Dortmund was Lewandowski's 300th for Bayern in all tournaments. He scored 259 goals. Since yesterday, we have said that Messi is experiencing some discomfort after playing with Dynamo Kiev. We've talked and decided that it would be better to leave him on the bench, said Koeman. Real Madrid reported that Eden Hazard and Casemiro tested positive for coronavirus. Edinson Cavani made his debut goal for Manchester United. He netted against Everton in the last minutes of the match. In the match against Betis, Antoine Griezmann missed his fourth penalty in a row for the club and the national team. If I score against Barcelona, I won't celebrate that, due to respect for my partners. But I gave all my strength for the Atletico shirt, said Suarez. Joshua Kimmich suffered a knee injury in the match against Borussia Dortmund. He will definitely not play for the national team with Ukraine and Spain. Liverpool will try to sign inter-central defender Milan Skriniar this winter. The goal against Betis was Ousmane Dembele's first one in La Liga since last year of October. Pedri scored his first goal for Barca in La Liga. He is not even 18 years old yet. Real Madrid is unhappy with the amount of playing time Reinier had in Borussia Dortmund. Madrid wants to return him by winter. Marcus Rashford, Luke Shaw and Victor Lindelof were injured in the match against Everton. Arsenal is seriously interested in Red Bull Salzburg midfielder Dominic Szoboszlai. Key players from Lazio, Ciro Immobile, Luis Alberto and Thomas Strakosha won't play in the match with Juventus due to coronavirus. Edouard Mendy conceded the first goal as Chelsea goalkeeper. An accurate shot was done by David McGoldrick of Sheffield United. Manchester United repeated its best record of consecutive away wins in the Premier League, with 7 of them. Previously, the record stood by Ferguson's reign. David Alaba gained his 200th Bundesliga victory. Romelu Lukaku has recovered from injury and will be able to play in the next match against Atalanta. Milan is pleased with Brahim Diaz's performance and wants to buy him from Real. Thilo Kehrer and Idriss Agaye didn't finish the match with Ren due to injuries. The severity of damages is still unknown. Christian Pulisic didn't play against Sheffield United due to a hamstring injury. As usual, there is a lot of football in the top leagues on Saturday. Here we are, showing you all the results. Now's the time for us to move on to the main news. Ready? Let's go! After a stream of failures, Manchester United got a huge win over Everton. Bruno Fernandes scored a brace. Another goal remains in the pocket of Cavani. This shot was the debut one for the Uruguayan in the United squad. Bernard has set an only goal for Everton. Chelsea's huge spending on strengthening the squad is finally starting to pay off. This time, the Blues rookie carried out the team in the match against Sheffield United. Chelsea conceded first from McGoldrick, but then just destroyed the Blades. Even before the break, Tammy Abraham scored with a pass from Mateo Kovacic. And Hakim Ziyech effectively crossed to the far post for Ben Chilwell to score. In the second half, Ziyech made a double of assists. The Moroccan perfectly delivered a free kick pass to Thiago Silva's head. That is the first goal of Brazilian for Chelsea's side. Timo Werner scores at the very end after going full 1-on-1. Just another brawl between Borussia D and Bayern turned out to be fiery. Despite all the efforts of Favre's team, the Munich team against got 3 points. In the middle of the first half, Lewandowski's goal was cancelled after watching the VAR due to a centimeter offside. And in the 45th minute, Royce brought the house ahead. Before the halftime whistle, Alaba pulled one back with an amazing free kick. Right after the break, Lewandowski scored with a perfect header from Lucas Hernandez's cross. This is his 13th goal in 8 recent matches against Borussia. What a machine he is! Leroy Sané scored his 3rd goal against Burkey after a great pass, and Erling Haaland beat Neuer in the 82nd minute and turned the intrigue with a shot into the empty net. But it was already too late. Bayern Munich again breaks out as a core leader of the Bundesliga. It also seems nice to see how Robert Lewandowski after the game supports still very young Haaland. At one time, the Polish felt for himself what it is like to lose to Bayern as the main hope of Borussia. For the first time this season, Ronald Koeman very unexpectedly left Lionel Messi on the bench. But even one half was enough for Barca legend to make a difference. During the first half, Barca had the advantage even without Messi. A beautiful goal was scored of the scoring race of the Spanish championship. Friends, we have noticed how much you loved our new project Top Football. So, there is a new video for you to discover. Top 5 injustices in football. Spoiler alert! It turned out, as usual, fiery and incredibly interesting. The video is in front of you, go ahead and watch! Well, we gotta say goodbye here. It was Football News. Have a nice one and see you in a bit!